Okay, so you might not be a fan of Apple, but you gotta admit, the Mac's pretty cool, man. Well, the operating system. The hardware's a little lackluster lately, but whether you are a freshman student in college looking for some productivity apps or you are a working video professional, macOS probably has something to suit your needs. Now, that's not to say that I don't like and use Windows and Linux, because I do, and those operating systems absolutely have their strengths. And macOS definitely has its weaknesses. But macOS is mine. That's why I learned how to use a computer. I prefer it, and a lot of people do. Shame on us, right? The problem is that the hardware is a little lackluster lately. It's becoming increasingly expensive, and reliability has gone down. There's not that many great options. So a lot of Apple people are actually moving to Hackintoshes, where you build a PC, and instead of installing Windows or Linux, you install macOS. I've done several of these builds in the past. Some very expensive ones, some less expensive ones, and some budget ones. My most recent budget build was all the way in the beginning of last year. I built a $350 Hackintosh. The problem with this machine was that I used all new parts, and buying new parts on the low end is really not a good value. You spend a lot for very little. And you're better off using hardware that's a couple of years old on the used market. A lot of old hardware still works really, really well. And so we're going to basically do a redux of that video, a brand new build with a $350 budget, except this time we are only using used parts that we find locally here in Salt Lake City. Can we do it? Let's find out. This video is sponsored by Dashlane, the all-in-one suite that manages your password, keeps you safe online, has a free VPN, and a heck of a lot more. Check it out with the link in the video description below. I've been pillaging my local classifieds for about the last hour, and my goodness, have I found a lot of really, really amazingly awful deals. There are some people that think their computers are worth so much more than they're worth, like 10, 12-year-old computers that they want several hundred dollars for. But I have found, after much belaboring, a system that I think is pretty decent for the price. On the CPU side, we've got an Intel i5-6400. This is a Skylake CPU. It's going to be very reliable. You really want to build a Hackintosh on Intel. Trust me on this one. You can do it on certain AMD chipsets, especially the new Ryzen chips, but keeping them stable is a real bear. It's not fun to deal with. So just go Intel. This Skylake CPU will be more than adequate. On the motherboard side, we have contacted this guy on Facebook, and he's got a bunch of them in this rack. And he has an a Gigabyte Z270 board, which is actually probably a really excellent board for $60. And I've messaged him to see if we can get that down to $50. But even at $60, that's a pretty good buy. RAM. So I've decided to go with 8 gigs of HyperX Fury DDR4 memory. Now this runs at 2133 megahertz, which is actually a pretty decent clock speed. Not super fast, but not very slow either. And it's dual channel. There was one DIMM of 8 gigs for a little bit less money, but I decided to go with a slightly more expensive dual stick configuration because you really want to run memory in dual channel with multiple sticks. On the GPU front, GPUs have come down a lot in price point, thank goodness. Now there are actually a lot of AMD GPUs that are very affordable. And I do recommend the later AMD Radeon GPUs for your Mac because they are natively supported in macOS 10, no drivers required. NVIDIA chips have worked historically, but Mojave, they still don't have current drivers. Just use the ones that Apple uses and they're guaranteed to work. So any of the recent generation AMD chips are going to be great. And this RX 480 for $70 is a pretty decent deal. This is where things get a little bit sketchy because we are stretching the budget out much further than we should. It is a 120 gig SSD hard drive. It's not what they're called, guy. But $25, it's not a great deal. It's probably a really crappy SSD, but hey, we need to stay under budget. And then lastly, we've got a PSU. Do not cheap out on PSUs. When you're building a PC, I know that seems like something you want to cut the corner on. Don't do it. Buy a nice power supply. But I'm not going to do that because we have a budget to fit under. So we're paying $20 for this power supply. It should work okay, but I don't recommend something like this long term. And then a case. We have a few dollars left for a case. I have no idea what we're going to do. Let's figure it out. Believe it or not, it was actually pretty tricky to find a PC case for a reasonable price on Craigslist. So we actually went to our local electronics recycler that sold us an older than the hills NZXT tower and a power supply for $10. Now, they're not amazing and they're not going to win any design competitions, but they're functional. And most importantly, they meet our $350 budget. The software side of a Hackintosh can either be really simple or really complex, depending on your mix of hardware. So I would recommend Googling the model number of your motherboard. If you find someone who's done a build similar to your own, it's probably okay to proceed. If you haven't, maybe take a step back and reevaluate your hardware options. You see, there are really two methods of installing macOS on a PC. One is using tools from a website called TonyMac. They're excellent for beginners. More experienced builders typically do what's called a vanilla install. They don't like using the TonyMac tools because they're closed sourced and whatever. That's what I do now as a more experienced builder, but I absolutely recommend you check out TonyMac if you're building a first-time Hackintosh. But regardless, you need to know that this is not plug and play. It's going to take some troubleshooting, it's going to take some diagnosing, and you are going to have to do your due diligence, reading up before you actually proceed. Okay, guy, but how does your computer perform? Honestly, for $350, shockingly well. And this is yet again evidence that using used parts is the way to go. Because compared to last year's $350 Hackintosh build using new parts, we absolutely clobber that machine. In fact, the Hackintosh this year benchmarks just barely behind the i3 quad-core Mac Mini. Now, that machine is a lot smaller, but at less than half the cost, this machine, it's nothing to balk at. Cinebench R20, which we just started benchmarking, tells a very similar story. But real-world performance is really where things matter. And Final Cut Pro 10, well, let's just say this little Hackintosh's GPU starts to flex its muscles. Because the $350 Hackintosh with its metal-accelerated RX 480 GPU handily outperforms the i3 Mac Mini at $800. This is a great system. Now, I could have saved about $50 had I shopped for parts online, but I'm impressed. It's not as small as the Apple Mac Mini or my Nutcracker Hackintosh that I did a couple of months ago, but it does have a full-size GPU. You could boot into Windows and game on this thing. All in all, it's a fantastic value, just like our sponsor, Dashlane. Dashlane is the only tool that you need to stay safe online. Stop worrying about having weak or reused passwords, because Dashlane has a superb built-in password manager that autofills on both desktop and mobile. And stop worrying about someone monitoring your internet history, because it has a full-featured, fast, multi-country VPN with server location selection. Stop worrying about privacy and data breaches, because Dashlane tells you about them if your passwords have been compromised. Dashlane has a basic free version, but with Dashlane Premium, the power of 3 to 4 pro tools are bundled into one inexpensive subscription. You don't just get value in Dashlane's features, but peace of mind knowing that you're protected from every angle. Sign up today with the link below and save 10% when you sign up with Dashlane Premium using my code. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you enjoyed this video, give it a like, but most importantly, and as always, stay snazzy. You know